I'd like to point out respect. Respect is given to seniority. The Bible talks about respect, given double honor for a minister. If a minister has seniority, you give him respect for that seniority. I'm going to draw a difference. If a minister commits a mistake, the prophet said, if the man leaves the word, leave that man and follow the word. But doesn't it mean you disrespect the person? You still love him as a brother. So, in contrast with seniority, there is revelation. We follow the word. We follow Jesus Christ. We don't follow a flesh of a man. We don't have an emotional attachment. We give him respect, whom respect is due, but it does not mean your whole eternity is in his hands. So there's a difference how we treat persons with seniority, who has seniority or has revelation. Let's say someone shares to you about Acts 2:38. It's biblical, but he's not your pastor. Let's say your pastor is a Trinitarian. You learned many things from him. Just so happened, there are certain subjects that he could not comprehend. Now, if you love God, you love Jesus Christ, you follow what the Bible says. Even if your pastor tells you, do not be baptized in Jesus' name, that sometimes the conflict will arise from there. But it does not mean you will disrespect him. You always give him a chance to prove his side out. You always show deference to him. That's what the prophet had in his experience. Who was his pastor for? Forget the name. Roy Davis. Even he was Baptist, even he instructed something different from his own convictions. But he went his way. Our fathers in flesh may commit mistake, but we still love him. That doesn't mean we will follow his mistake. So, Brother Branham was clear cut in giving this instruction. If the man departs the word, you depart from the, it doesn't mean you disrespect. You follow the word. Now, there is another issue with division. No, not all divisions are from the devil, and not all unity is from God. So there is a God-given division. There is a man-made division. This is what I believe is a God-given division. If a certain group of people wants to follow the word, they get ostracized by their group. The prophet experienced that, Martin Luther experienced that. For the sake of unity, just forget about it. No, I have to steer clear of my conscience. My conscience is captivated by the word. It's sometimes the word that gives us the division. When Christ said, I bring a sword, he was referring to doctrinal differences. Now, let's be clear about how we are going to act on this. Because people using this verse, they will just immediately separate themselves, condemning the other. How is the right way of God-given division? You believe the word, but you do not impress upon the others to believe as you do. But actually, division takes place. It was the other side who will persecute the one who is walking on the truth. The one walking on the truth has love for the other side who has not yet understood his revelation. But it will be the other side who will persecute, ostracize, malign, run down his reputation. It has taken place all throughout the ages. It's taking place even today. So, God-given division, the Nicolaitan spirit within those people will cause the division. But actually, it's fulfilling God's purpose, separating the wheat from the tares. My definition of tares and wheat is not so much in the details of the doctrine. Oh, you've got a doctrinal, you've got the doctrinal differences. Let's see in the end who is the tear. No. The attitude. The opposite of the spirit of Nicolaitanism is the spirit of
Berreanism.
I just coined this word just to simplify what the prophet has been saying. Love the brother. Let's share it with, clear it out with him. Do not misrepresent him. Get his side of the story. Most of the time, the spirit of Nicolaitanism will prevent the person from checking the evidence out from the word. Will implant emotions for the person. He might even develop hatred for another brother, not because he received something wrong from the brother, but because from whispers, murmurings, influences. The person is not taught on how to on the love of being just and fair, justice, mercy, and truth. So, God-given division, a segment of God's people, predestinated seed from the foundation of the world, will hear the progressive word, and the rest of his peers of his original church will drive him away. It's not they who wanted to separate himself, because they would not. They want to prove all things, but the other would not. They do. They even command them, don't talk about it anymore. Don't even research about it. Don't even get the other side. Those in the truth will not be afraid to prove all things. It's not by hatred, but by love. This would be true. Let's check it out. No, don't check it out. The management, the administration tells you, do not check it out. Man-made division could be caused by two things. One, the one mentioned by a brother, a wrong motive. There's no doctrinal division. There are personal reasons. They hate each other or what? They could not resolve things for the wrong reasons. Now, there are idealistic people. It's not because of personal wrong reasons, but they consider doctrinal reasons. He has fallen in error. We have to separate ourselves. It happened in our church, Pastor Gledon's church. Okay. This, what they considered as doctrinal reasons, actually is, again, the Nicolaitan spirit. This man-made division, they do not want to prove all things. They do not want to check it out. They just want to plant emotions to people and immediately judge he's wrong. Separate yourselves from him. So in my own experience, without fair due process, those people come from within, influence maybe from the outside, influencing others who are not even related, who are not even involved, to separate from me. Well, talk about harmony. If there's biblical love, there would be no problem. But this is spirit that we have to contend with while we are here. Last verse.